Given the number of former Obama administration officials that are now in this Biden administration and the president's relatively light schedule, there's a growing perception that this is really just the third term of President Obama. What do you say to people who say that?
Who were saying that? Who's saying that?
You hear that a lot in the media.
Who in the media?
Different people.
Like?
Well, there was lots of questions about when you had Japanese Prime Minister Suga here on the one and only so far in-person bilateral head of state meeting. It was Vice President Kamala Harris who greeted the Prime Minister. Many people found that odd. She's already taking independent one-on-one calls with key allies like Prime Minister Morrison and Justin Trudeau. So I just want to get your reaction to people who question that.
Well, it's hard to react when I don't know what people you're talking about. I will say that the President met with the Prime Minister, as you know, and had a full meeting, a full press conference afterwards, and they even shared a meal. So, and the President has had dozens of conversations and calls with world leaders, and should be no surprise that the Vice President is also playing an important role, engaging with and having discussions with foreign leaders.
It's more so than other Vice Presidents have.
How so? I'd love to see the data. If you want to give me, present that to us.
Provide you with that sometimes, and
sure.
Would love to get your reaction on it.
Would welcome it.
Excellent. And then on the coronavirus, it's a matter of public record that Dr. Fauci and the NIH-funded gain-of-function experimentation research at the Wuhan Lab of Virology. And given the questions about that lab, why would Dr. Fauci and the U.S. fund that kind of experiments, that kind of research in a Chinese lab?
I'm sorry, I can't hear you super well. What was the beginning part of your question?
I said that the NIH and Dr. Fauci had provided funding to the Wuhan Lab of Virology. That's the lab in question when we talk about the lab leak theory. And given that gain-of-function research is dicey, why would the U.S. fund that in China?
I'm happy to send you to the NIH about more specifics of what program they funded and more details of that.
Now, I do have one more follow-up on that because the president hasn't really weighed in. Dr. Fauci is one of the voices who discredit the lab leak theory, but now there's more officials in the Biden administration, like the Director of National Intelligence, the CIA director, and now also the NIH director, who say that this cannot be ruled out, and there's calls for more investigation into it. Who does the president agree with, Dr. Fauci or the other officials? Does he think it was a lab leak?
Well, the president has said, and I've said from here many times, that there needs to be a credible, independent investigation through the World Health Organization, and that one that relies on data, relies on participation from China and other countries that may have information. That's certainly something everybody has called for, and we look forward to that happening.
Spoken with President Xi about the origins of the coronavirus yet? He said just a few weeks ago he hadn't yet.
I think we have given a readout of his call, and also that the president believes there should be an independent investigation led by health experts, and one where their data is provided, that's provided transparently to our medical and science experts here in the United States, and we look forward to reviewing that. We're going to have to go on. Go ahead. I'm sorry, Emerald. I think you've had plenty of time today. Go ahead.
Worst motherfucker never loved us. Fucker never loved us. You ain't know now, you know now. Still at the scrub J's with a toothbrush. Shit, niggas still playing my old shit. But your shit is like the police asking us questions. Nigga, we don't know shit. Flex. Nigga, I'm just flex. Nigga never loved us. Do it love like we stress. Look at you, look at you, and look at you.
Go ahead. They're really showing themselves to do really well. Come on, man.